want my worship through intimidation or fear. He wants my worship through reverence. He keeps loving me. And when he loves me, he disarms me. So that it is my joy to worship him. And it will break my heart to break his heart. Because he keeps showing me how much he loves me. And so watch this. So Jacob thinks that he can deceive God. But he's imprinted that way. That's how he figured this out. So Jacob, watch this, is cultural now. Say with me, cultural. So he's not biblical, he's just cultural. How is that? Because his mom and dad, even though they are the recipients of God's grace, they teach their son the culture. Not the law, come on, but the culture. I'm going somewhere if y'all just can walk with me. So he thinks he can deceive God. Here's the second thing he understood. He understood that he could call on God when he got in trouble. Does Jacob sound like anybody you know? That he can call on when he's in trouble, he can call on God. Because every time he got in trouble, he was calling on God. Now watch this. He understood it because that's what he saw. Will y'all stay with me? So the whole issue of him wrestling with the angel was more about him. The only thing he got out of that fight, because notice what the angel says. The angel says, you've done what? Y'all have read the text, haven't you? You've done what? You prevailed. You won. How does a man win in a wrestling match with an angel? Angel, supernatural created being, man, flesh. Are we here? But the text says, he said, you prevailed. Come on, ask me how. Because the only way Jacob won is that Jacob won because he discovered the truth about himself. When you get the truth about you, you win. Oh, I thought that was a praise. I thought that was a praise. That was a praise break. When you get the truth about you, you win. And watch this. And until you get the truth, you're always wrestling. Because the real issue is, truth is always going to wrestle with the story you tell yourself. And you will never be at ease because God will never settle and you won't see the blessing of God until you come to terms with the truth of who you are and who you are not. Are you getting anything out of this? So watch this. Individuals being real about what you are and what you are not. And watch this. And it can't hide behind culture. Okay, hold on to your seats. You ready? We're going to take a sharp left, mother. You okay? Okay. We keep hiding behind our denomination. We hide on the fact that we are the fastest growing African-American Pentecostal denomination in the world. We hide behind 6.3 million members. We hide behind Bishop Charles Harrison Mason. We hide behind all the old fathers. Because it's easier to hide behind them than to tell the truth about us. It's easier to say that, you know, there's no more crutches on the wall and the goiters are not being thrown up and cancer, that's what the saints used to be, that's what the church used to be. Well, guess what? You can't hide behind Bishop Mason because he served his generation. He laid out a pattern for holiness, a pattern for the study of the Word of God, a passion for prayer, and a burden for souls. So we can't hide behind him because the real issue is, it's easier to hide behind him than to show that I have not brought one person into the kingdom and I've been saved for 20 years.
Talk.
Boy, I I should have just preached what I had prepared. Woo! This is fresh water. Because the real issue is, we're hiding. Come on, can I just walk this thing out for a second? Preachers, we're hiding. We're hiding with our lackadaisical passion for God because it's easier to do church than it is to do God. We don't really want to be engaged with dealing with folk and all of their mess, the cesspool of their problems, praying for them, walking, feeling their burden, because if I do that, I got no time for me. And at the end of the day, I'm the only thing that's really important. So I'll give God my attention, I'll give him a little something, but you know, God has got to fit into my life. Preachers really don't want to, they don't want to serve, they want to preach. They want to tell somebody how to do it, but they don't want to do it themselves. Now, I got this, ain't no pointing no fingers, I'm just being honest. Because we moved away from what Jesus said. Take no thought. He says, watch this, don't even take an extra coat. And if somebody asks you for your coat, give them your cloak also. Yes. If they want you to walk 1 mile, go 2. Yes. He said, don't take first, don't take script. He says, because I'm with you. The reason why we keep hiding behind our denomination, behind the great fathers of the church that have gone before us, is because we are like Nicodemus and we don't have no power. We cannot do anything with the situations we've been in addressing us because they're too big for us, because our up above ground looks like a castle, but below ground is nothing but sand. Ask him to lead you in a 3-day shut-in and a 90-day consecration. Ask him to give up their schedule to help. I'm just using preachers because I'm a preacher. But I'm just trying to make a point. Now I can go down the list, but I ain't gonna take it. Come on, missionaries. Don't even get me started. Are we here? Because one thing you'll notice about me, I'm not gonna do the bashing. I don't do that. But I'm gonna lift up the text. And I'm going to show you that we are not it. And as a result, the next time you ask the question, how come the church could, because you don't. It ain't got nothing to do with us. It's got everything to do with you. Because watch this, everybody's got to carry their own corner. I hear it. No, I got Bible for it. Want to hear it? Here it go. When they went in, what is it, Mark chapter 2? And they took the man that was sick of the palsy. The Bible says he was born by what? 4. So everybody grabbed the corner. And if you don't carry your corner, then watch this. The people, that man who is sick of the palsy, is not going to get to Jesus because you decided that I'd rather sleep in than carry a corner. That ain't my Sunday. That ain't my thing. And when you came to Christ, can I just stick with the preacher analogy? That whole collar is symbolic that I have given up my right to life. And anybody who comes in my life has got to understand that I've got somebody pulling my string. And watch this, he's calling me.